Hi guys, Ian here, and today we have a little sit-down video. Yes, we do. So I don't usually talk about like celebrity drama and all that kind of stuff, but I've talked about her before. Her name is Chrisean. I think I made like one other video on her. I'll leave it down below. She is my daughter's age. She is 23 years young. Her birthday's in March. So this coming March, so next month, she'll be 24 years old. And I feel for her. This girl went, and I'll explain the backstory. But why I'm making this video, this girl went and put this huge tattoo of her baby daddy, okay, that they call it now, on her face. And she is absolutely beautiful. And I see she's getting, I think they said she lost over a million followers on Instagram. She's down to, I think, 5.1, which is a lot. Let me look real quick. People are mad. They are losing their shit over this tattoo. And I have a little unpopular opinion. I don't like it, but I kind of understand where she's coming from. And I feel for her. I really think she needs help. I think that is the issue. She needs help. Yeah, she still has 5.1 million followers. I don't know exactly how many she lost, but you know. So she, Chrisean Rock is number 11 out of the children. I think there's 12 of them, and she was born number 11. She did not have her father in her life. Her father was locked up. I believe she first met her father when she was 7. He was in and out of jail and stuff like that. And then her mother was a drug addict, okay? So, I mean, she's shared this story before. And I think she was looking for attention, and sometimes you look for attention any way you can get, if it's good or if it's bad. And then you also look for a guy's attention, especially if you didn't have that father figure, the father figure you should have in your life. I've always said this, a girl's first love is their father. And I don't mean in a sexual manner. I mean, that's how they learn love and how they know how a man is supposed to treat you, how you feel protective, what is supposed to, a love is supposed to feel like, that protection and all that type of stuff. When you don't have that in your life, you go looking. For instance, I did, right? My mother, you know, she was a very good mother and loved me. She had issues, right? And my biological father died when I was 6, you know, so I didn't have a father figure growing up. Even like grandparents, you know, like I had a grandfather. He wasn't my biological grandfather, but he was very mean. He was a drunk and he died when I was young. I had one uncle in my life, which wasn't, you know, but my family, the guys, they were not around, you know. And so I went looking. I wanted that. I was yearning that family that I never had. I never seen a healthy wife and husband marriage ever, you know. The only marriage I really ever seen was my grandmother and grandfather, and he used to beat her, and he was mean, and you know, I don't really want to get into that, but that wasn't healthy. My mother had one relationship after my father. I was a teenager. That was only about a year and a half. That wasn't good. The first guy when I was 17 who told me they loved me, I mean, I had a kid with him within 4 months, you know. It's like I yearned that, and I stayed with him because I want, and he was abusive, but I wanted that mother, father, and baby, what I never had. I started getting in trouble at an early age. I've shared this many times. I was not in a gang, but a lot of my friends were, and I did things I should not have done and got in trouble. And I mean, the last time I was sentenced to 4 years in prison. I mean, you know, really, really bad things I was doing that I'm not proud of, but I did it because I thought, oh, these are my family. They love me, you know, like my friends, you know, and you know, and it was just sad. And so I see a lot of that in her. And I see, like, I think she started on the Zeus networks on the baddies. I think she did like 3 seasons with them, and then she had her own little show, her and her boyfriend, Blueface, which, you know. And I think that's what it was. She liked that attention she was getting. And friend that she got with Blue, and, you know, he already had a girlfriend. I think they had two kids together, Jaden, Alexis, I think her name is. And then, like, she gets pregnant. I mean, he was going back and forth. Remind me of my son's father back in the day. He would go back and forth. When I met him, he had already had two kids, and I get with him. Didn't know they were only broken up for 3 weeks because he lied to me. I get pregnant 4 months later. Behind the scenes, he was going back to both of us. I would live with them. We would break up. She would move back in. When they would break up, I would move back in, because then me and this girl, we'll call her Sally, we made it more personal. It wasn't really that I wanted him. It was like, aha, I got him. He loves me. Stupid, you know? But you do that when you're young. And she is young. Now, when I was growing up, I'm 47 years old. So when I had my first son, it was in 1995. I got with the father in 1994. And back then in the 90s, you know, tattoos weren't really popular. Yeah, sure, people got them, but it's nothing like it is now. I mean, back then, if you dyed your hair blue or green, you got looked at and you were called a weirdo or a freak or what have you. And you couldn't hang around these type of people. You know, they were very judged. It's not like it is now. It was not acceptable to have all these tattoos. Jobs would not hire you at all if they knew you had tattoos and stuff. You know, it was very judgy and judgmental back then. And so, you know, nobody would ever get a tattoo of them. You know, you might have got a tattoo when you're, you know, somewhere you can cover up, but it wasn't a thing. Because I don't know if it was a thing back then. I don't think I would get anything on my face, but I might to show them, oh, I love you. I mean, you know, it's like she's thinking immaturely because she is immature. She's young. Yeah, people might say, well, she's 23. She should know better. But not with the upbringing she had. You have to remember the upbringing she had. And anyway, she's getting attention. So she'll show her body off and she's got a nice figure because that's where she's getting the attention. She's making her money by acting a fool online. Everybody says, oh my God, I'm so disappointed. But we're all watching. We're watching her Instagram, all her stories, all of that stuff. It's making her money, right? Nobody liked her in blue face together. You know, we would hit her and all this other kind of stuff. They were both abusive to each other, but everybody watched it. You know, it's like you're putting money in her hands, and she's looking at it like more money, more money, more money. She don't care what you guys are saying. The more the public is saying, don't be with this guy, he's no good, he's messing with all these people, she's going to stay. I say this all the time when people talk about Jessica Kent, and that's another video I'm going to make on. So many people say Jessica Kent shouldn't be with this guy Burner now, and this and that. The more people are making videos, the more she's going to stay just to prove you guys wrong. Even if their relationship isn't healthy, even if she knew the relationship isn't healthy, she's going to stay because she wants to prove to you guys are wrong. It's the truth. When I got with my son's father, a lot of my family disowned me because I was dating outside my race. And at that time, my son's father was abusive and different things, you know, but I stayed. I never told my mom and all that because I didn't want them to say, see, I told you, he's no good. So I made it like everything was good until finally I just couldn't. Tyler was 3 years old and I had to get away. We broke up numerous times, you know, But the more my mother and my grandmother and whoever said, you know, he's no good, get away from him, I had to prove them wrong. You guys don't know what you're talking about. He loves me, right? And that's what because I was young. And that's what these people are doing. Yeah, Jessica Kent is a little bit older and has two kids. But still, some people, when they have a mind frame, by Jessica Kent's upbringing, a lot of girls and young women and women that didn't grow up with a father figure are like this. And they don't handle, they think everything is hate and negative when it's just out of love and you're trying to help. But at that time, we're not looking at it like that. We're looking at, oh, you hate and I'm going to show you. People go about it wrong when you make these negative videos because all they're going to do is try to prove you wrong. You know what I mean? And they're not going to leave who they want until they're ready. No matter how many times people told me to leave, like my husband now, we just got divorced. He was no good for me, but I wanted to stay because I wanted to work on my marriage. No matter how many people say, Ann, he's not helping with bills. What is he doing for you? He's not doing anything. What is he improving? He's making your life worse. You don't need him. I had to prove to everybody my marriage can work. I can make my marriage work until I couldn't anymore. Until I was ready to say, no, I can't do this no more. Nobody could tell me anything. It would make me want to stay even more. You know what I mean? And I don't think Chrisean Rock has a positive person in her life to say, what the hell are you doing? And I don't think anybody will because they want that money. She has yes people, even her family. You know, they're not going to tell her nothing because she's the type of person, she likes to fight and she'll fight and disown you and all that. So some people like to stay because they want to be part of everything. Now, this Blue, he's locked up on parole violation. I think he gets out in like 6 to 8 months or whatever. And anybody knows when you are locked up. I know, when I was locked up, right? You start thinking differently. You see who comes around, who doesn't. You find out who your friends are. But, you know, so at that time, you're in a different path. And you may mean it at the time, but when you get out, it's something totally different, right? A lot of men talk to different girls, and they tell them all the things they want to hear because they want them to put money on their books. They want you to come visit them. They are playing you, okay? And you know, she has this baby, and she openly said she had abortions before, you know, so now she has this baby, and I believe she feels that this baby's going to keep them together. But he was with somebody else, Jaden Alexis, and already had two kids, and she couldn't keep him from going around. How you get them is how you lose them, right? So if you're in a relationship, and you know this person has somebody and has kids by him, and you mess with them, and yeah, they might get with you at that time, but they're going to do the same thing to you. You know, it's like my husband, he committed adultery and he's with this woman, right? While we were still married and stuff. And it's like, what does this woman think he's going to do? You think he's going to stay? Or does he think she's going to stay? No, it's a challenge sometimes when people realize they're in a relationship or married because they want to have this challenge, like I can get him. And then when they do get him, they realize what they got and they don't want it no more. The challenge is done. You know what I mean? And I just feel bad for her. I see all this hate, and it's like she needs a positive role model. I mean, I'm serious. She said that she got this tattoo because she's going to prove to him that what did she say exactly? Like, ain't no woman gonna ever do this for him. And if they do, then they copied me. I'm a trendsetter. And it's like, he is laughing at you because does he have any tattoos of you? She had this big thing on her neck, okay? They break up. He gets back with his baby mom, and he also cheats on her and everything else. So she gets it covered up. Now, Jaden and him broke up. So now he's talking good to her because while he's locked up, he needs somebody to live in his house to keep the bills being paid and all this other kind of stuff, right? He's playing her, in my opinion, okay? And he's playing other women, in my opinion, okay? Because women are saying this. And it's like, so now she moves into his house and she gets this tattoo because she thinks they're back together. Well, she's so beautiful, but she reminds me of the type of person you can't tell her nothing. She's going to do what she wants to do. And I actually feel sorry for her because I remember that. I remember, oh my God, like even in just my marriage, and I was older at the time, but especially when I was young, you know, I was so stupid because I wanted to make him happy. I was a people pleaser. And if I was this way, he would love me. And we have kids together. That don't mean nothing. That means nothing. Nothing. When a man cheats on you and you allow it and you get back with him, they keep doing it. They don't respect you. If a man truly loves you, they're not going to want to hurt you or cheat on you or put their hands on you. And it's like all these, you're getting these tattoos of him. He don't have not one tattoo of you. He's not going to. She thinks by getting this tattoo, this is impressing him. And she feels that she's showing her love to him by getting this big tattoo. So that way, every man will see her because he's a very jealous person, okay? And that's why they got in a lot of fist fights and different things like that. So now she branded him basically to show him, see, now everybody can see you're my man. See, and what she doesn't understand is right now, reality TV and all this stuff, like, and as long as you're making the money and you have this internet success and all this stuff, yeah, you're gaining money. But how long is this going to last? It doesn't last forever. And that's what she's not thinking. And what happens when he finds somebody else and he gets with her? Just what happened with Jaden Alexis. She finally got so sick of it, she finally left him for good. She moved on to another relationship and she's done with him. You know? It's sad, and it makes me feel bad because I've always said for me, I wish I had a positive role model in my life or a positive friend in my life at that time to say, wake up, Anne, what the hell are you doing? These people that you think you're friends with aren't your friends. When I got sentenced to 4 years, I thought, let me tell you, I mean, some of the things I've already shared, okay? Drive-bys, home invasions, armed robbery. I can keep going. And that's the truth. I would be with them if somebody owed somebody money. I was with them while they broke the door in, and I'm taking the, wiping fingerprints off, and even though we had gloves and all that kind of stuff, but still, you know, helping them out because I'm like, these are my friends. When I need help, all I had to do, call and say, let's just say the internet. Back then, there was no internet, okay? There wasn't social media or anything like that, nothing. I mean, there were cell phones, but that was for people that had money. They had beepers, but that was about it. But let's just say it was how it is now back then. And let's say somebody made a video on me, okay? Or did something I didn't like. I can make one phone call and get your house shot up, okay? Or what have you. And so I thought these are my friends they did for me because they have done things for me, you know? And people were scared of me. Nobody messed with me because they knew. They said one thing bad to me. Their family's burying them. And that's the truth. And I'm not just talking. That is the truth. So I thought these people are my friends and I did things with them until something had happened that I took the blame for, which I did not do, but I didn't snitch at that time because I was young and dumb, thinking, oh, I'm their friend. They could see how loyal I am. They were so scared. They all ratted on me, which I didn't even do it because they were too scared to go to jail. Okay? Snitches. All right? Scared. And these are some, one of my friends, they called him suicide because he didn't care if he died or not. Crazy, okay? Which he did pass away, he got shot and stuff. But when I got locked up and got sentenced to 4 years, okay, I realized then they only used me because I was there. When I wasn't around, they just hung with other people that were stupid. They didn't care about me. If they cared about me, they wouldn't allow me to go to jail when I was the only one that had a kid at the time. You know what I'm saying? When I was doing drugs, when I was drinking and drugging, okay, and thought these people are my friends coming over, we're partying, all this kind of stuff. When I got clean, guess what? All they did was go to the next person's house and drink and drug, okay? I didn't hear from them. People don't care, you know? And I had to learn that the hard way. You know, I remember my son's father, I thought, oh my God, I can never have him out of my life. What am I going to do? I don't even think about him now. Time does heal, right? You don't think about him, but when you're young, it's more puppy love. And it's, especially when you have a baby by him. And I think her son is only literally a couple months old. He's not that old. So you think you want this, especially if you didn't have that male role model and you want it. And you think that, oh, he loves me. He's so jealous. I know that feeling. He's so jealous that he's hitting me because he's jealous. So he must love me. What? But that's how our minds are trained to work because we just want it so bad. We want the relationship. We want to feel love. We want that in our lives, that mother, father, baby, family, that we accept it and we put in our minds, this is love. And people that never experienced this or didn't have the upbringing that she did and the lifestyle that she did growing up or around a parent that was on drugs or a father that wasn't around, if you have an experience that you don't know, so many people can judge. Oh, she's so stupid. Why is she doing that? Why? Because she doesn't have a positive role model in her life and she needs help. And all these people that are saying all these bad things, all you're doing is making it to where she's going to say, what you talking about? We're in love. We're making all this money. We're making millions. And blah, blah, blah. Because she just wants to prove to you guys. You're not going to make her leave. All these videos, it's not going to make her leave. All these people calling her stupid about the tattoo. She's getting offended. She's feel like it's more hate. And there's nothing you can tell her. you know? You're just adding on to her. She is one of those types that she'll get more to prove to you guys. And she's not going to learn until she sees it herself. It took that Jade and Alexis, what, 10, 11 years to realize no. And I feel bad for her. And I pray for her every night. I pray for a lot of people. But I do. I pray for her. And I just hope she gets some good guidance around her. I don't know how much, if you can get that taken off. I know good makeup can help, you know. But what is she going to do when all this internet fame and everything dies down? What type of job are you going to get? What type of man, if you and Blueface don't work out, what type of man is going to want to be with you with the, you know, imagine being in bed, a guy, and he's on top of you. And I don't mean to sound off, but this is the truth. And you turn your head and he sees this guy on there. He's going to he's going to get up and be like, what the hell? He's going to get soft real quick. And I know that's a little too TMI, but it's true. No man is going to want to see another man's face right there. And she only did it to prove to Blue, see, I told you I love you. And she branded herself. But I had to learn at my age, at 47 years old, people can say whatever they want. You can say, oh, that is my best friend. I love her. Or, oh, that's my man. I love him. Or, that's my girl. That's my woman. People can say whatever they want. I could say, oh, everybody knows Lisa's my best friend. Lisa, you are my best friend. I love you. Then hang out with her, call somebody up and be like, I can't stand her. Blah, 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 blah. You know, that's how people are. Okay? How you show them is by actions. Okay? Like Lisa and my friend Jody, right? They show me they care about me by their actions. Okay? My husband did not. Yeah, he might have said he loved me, but how did he show me? He didn't pay any bills. He never put his hands on me. Towards the end, he threatened to do it, but he never did it. But he didn't show me love. He didn't spend time with me. He didn't take me out on my birthdays and stuff and take me out to eat and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, he was here. He was in the other room. But what does that mean? You know? It was probably because he didn't have any money to put gas in the car. But he didn't show me love. And I had to learn that. I had to learn that friends can tell you anything. And then screenshot things that you tell on personal, whatever the case may be, and then show it to other people. I've had that done. I've had it to where there's like group chats or whatever they're called, discords or whatever, and people are talking about me. So you can't trust people because of people that you think you can trust, right? Because what they do is they screen record and they send it to me. It's sad. And I learned, I just say, I stay quiet because I used to be the type of person, oh, I seen this. Why did you do this? No. When I don't care for somebody, we get into a fight, I don't block you off my phone. No, that's dumb. Because I want to keep it open to see, well, what will happen in the future? What do you have to say? Do you know what I mean? It's weird, but I don't know. I just have a different way of thinking now. You can have a friend that says, oh, you know, you're my best friend and stuff, but do they remember your birthday? Do they always forget your birthday? When people are invested in you in a friendship relationship, they remember. If they can't remember, guess what they do? They put it in their calendar like I do all the time. So that way, the night before, you know, it says ding, 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 so-and-so's birthday or what have you, whatever the case may be. Because I want to remember and be the first one to say happy birthday. Wedding anniversaries, everything I put on my phone in my calendar. And that's how you can tell when people care about you. It's not by words. And Blueface can say all he wants and tells her he loves her and all this kind of stuff. But what is he doing to show her? By beating her ass? By cheating on her? He doesn't have her branded anywhere. What is he showing her? Because he got her... she keeps going back to where, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I'm at now. Because I guess he's the one who found her and put her on these reality shows and all this. But what she's not understanding, yes, God does this. God puts people, places, and things in our lives. And sometimes it's for a season, a reason, a lifetime, or what have you. And sometimes he puts certain people in your life because you need them to get to where you have to be. Okay, it's like a stepping stone. But because of her and her personality is why she made it the way how far she made it. Not because of him. She keeps going back to him instead of giving herself grace and giving herself credit. She did it because of her. People like her. Hence why they're so mad that she's still with this guy and got back with him and brained at her face with him. you know, because they all know what he's about. Because sometimes when you're on the inside, you don't see it, but people on the outside can. You know what I mean? No matter what we say or do, she's not going to listen. And I feel sorry for her. And all we could do, if you really care, pray for her. That's all that we can do. Or send her good jujus if you're not the praying type. That's all we can do. I stayed with my husband for 11 years. And so many people were like, why are you with him? Why? And until I couldn't is when I got out of it. Does that make sense? I stayed with a man that didn't pay any bills. Okay? Didn't show me love. Came home complaining all the time. I felt like I was walking on eggshells because I wanted to prove and because I was married. And I liked the fact of being married and saying, my husband. And I didn't want to be lonely. And I needed health insurance and different things. I mean, it sounds stupid. But when I was in it, that's just how I felt. I was very insecure and lonely. So I'd rather put up with that treatment than nothing at all. And now that I see it differently, I love me. I love being single. I'm glad that I'm divorced. I am in peace. I am happy. You know what I mean? But it took me 11 years. And I just hope she's so young. And everything is life lessons and experiences. And that's what I try to do on this channel is explain. And that's why I talk about my personal life a lot, what I'm going through, what I have been through. Because I do believe as you get older, you get wisdom and by life lessons, right? I've learned. It took me a while, but I learned. It's actions, not by people's words. And I had to learn that the hard way. What do you guys think? Like, maybe you guys don't even know what I'm talking about, but I think I feel so passionate because I used to be like that. And I have a daughter that age, and I see the difference with my daughter. Her father, maybe not was always in her life, but majority of her life. He may not have helped pay child support and stuff like that, but he was always there. She knew who her father was. He would do anything for her, you know? Anything. I see the difference in her than when I was her age, right? She don't take nothing from no man. She's very secure, okay? She's working and all that to get her own self, okay? She don't need a man. And she makes it very clear. Now, she does have a boyfriend. He's very good to her. But it's because she doesn't allow the disrespect. It's so different. You can see when a girl has a positive male role model in their life. And my daughter don't remember me drinking and all that. I stopped doing that when my kids were young. They don't know me on that level. You know what I'm saying? So I've always been in their life as well. So I see how the cycle has been broken. And yeah, my daughter has a whole lot of tattoos, a whole lot, but not of no man. She has a lot of Bible verses, a lot of other things. She has a neck tattoo, not on her face. She wanted to. And I was like, you better not, you know, but she's got covered. I mean, she's got all up her leg, even on her ass cheeks, everything. And they're beautiful, beautiful tattoos, right? But not of no man. I tell her all the time. Maybe if you get married, okay? But even then, you don't know. And you know what Lexi told me? She goes, Mommy, I would never get no man's name on me. You know, she goes, unless it's my son. And I'm like, amen to that. But yeah, I think that's what it is. And I just feel for her. So let me know if you know the story and what do you think. And do you agree with me or do you disagree? And it's just sad. And I was really hoping that it was a fake tattoo. I really was. But she keeps saying it was real. It just breaks my heart. Mm. And I think sometimes we need to be more empathetic instead of so mean and triggered and realize that she just needs help and we need to pray for her or send her good jujus, you know? Instead of saying she's dumb. I hear that so many times. If you go watch, looking right now, Christian rock and all that, most people are saying how dumb she is and this and this and this. And it's like, that's not what she needs to hear. She needs to hear love. And she needs to hear, you're beautiful. You are worth something. You are the, you know, that's what she needs to hear. Not, you're dumb, you're stupid, because that's not helping. That's only making her stay even more. You know what I mean? All right, I'm going to get off of here and I'm going to try to edit this video. Hopefully I can get it up today. If not, it will be up in the morning. And yeah, that's everything, guys. Don't forget, I do have a beauty channel if you're interested in that. And yeah, I'm surprised you can still see her. By this time, she's usually way up there. All right, I'm going to cook some dinner. I'm making a buffalo chicken the kids want and mac and cheese and I don't know what else. But all right, guys, please thumbs up this video. It really does help me out. I'm trying to really grow this channel this year. So the more thumbs up I get, it helps me out. Make sure you leave a comment. Commenting really helps out with engagement. It would mean the absolute world to me and to Nala, even though she likes to play hard to get. Stay beautiful, stay blessed, stay healthy, and most importantly, always stay you. Never let somebody take you out of character. Do as I say, not as I do. And always believe in yourself. All right. Bye, guys.